and bring the truth channel, where we expose the truth, the gospel truth, that is. And we're going to jump into the fifth video of the Saved series, which is how to build a relationship with God. This I know personally because I actively built my relationship with God. Quick little short story. Me and my sister were in the car and we were sitting there, and God came through her, spoke through her. How I know it was God is because I was afraid. Not like scared I'm gonna lose my life afraid, but a reverence afraid, like the Almighty afraid. It was a healthy fear. And he broke down everything I needed to do to get closer to him. Teresa Gloria asked for me, and I'm going to sit here and tell you guys what it is. So the first thing in how to build a relationship with God is to spend time with God. I know every day we wake up feeding our flesh. We grab our phone to scroll, to make ourselves laugh. We eat whatever we want to eat. We watch whatever we want to watch. We listen to music and whatever we want to do. That's feeding your flesh on an everyday, regular basis. Some of those things are going to have to stop in order for you to get close to God as you want it to be. If you want to reap the benefits of this walk with Christ, give him your time. Jesus and God are outside of time. They look at time. We are in the confines of time. So while you have time here, speak to him. Talk to him. What I like to tell people is that heaven is going to be a consistent praise. That's all we're going to be doing, is just giving praise to God, spending time with God. So if you cannot, and you're unwilling to do that here on earth, well, what makes you think you're going to be ready when you get to heaven? What makes you think you're going to know how to speak to God when you get there if you don't know how to do it now? It's not going to magically just come to you. You have to spend time with him. The next thing you're going to do to grow your relationship with God is take up your cross. You hear that all day. Take up your cross. Take up your cross. Especially for new Christians. If you heard take up your cross, that literally means to die to yourself. The old Jake, Hannah, Brittany, whatever your name is. The old you is dead and gone now. You are following Christ. You are following Christ now. So that means to throw away the old you and let God bring in the new you. So if the old you smoked a lot, drank a lot, had a lot of sex, went out with friends, partied a lot, you got to give those things up. Give them up to get the glory that God has for you. And honestly, once you actually give them up, you will realize how much control they had over you. You won't realize until you actually give it up. Like when people say they're celibate, you won't realize how much celibacy does well for your mental. When you don't engage in sex a lot, when you stop smoking, or when you stop drinking, or when you stop partying, whatever it is that you did on a consistent, everyday, all day basis, and you finally give it up for the Lord, he will reveal to you all the things that you weren't able to see when you were under the cloud of whatever drug or alcohol it was. He will begin to answer some questions and answer prayers and reveal things to you that you thought you would never have answers to. It's because you have a clear mind now. The Bible says, be sober. We're supposed to be sober. And I know that's easier said than done. You know, I still struggle with my, with me smoking. It's still a struggle of mine. However, I came to God being honest. I was like, God, I don't want to stop smoking weed. Like, you know my heart. I don't have a desire to stop smoking weed. But what I do want to do is stop putting it above you. I don't want to spend my days high, but I also want to spend my days with you. So, I came up with not like an agreement, because it's not like God is like, well, we just gonna do this. But it's like an agreement in a way, like a covenant, where it's like, I won't smoke weed throughout the day. I won't smoke weed when the sun is up. When I have stuff to do, I won't smoke weed. The only time I consume marijuana is when I'm about to go to sleep. It's so that I can sleep throughout the night. And not because I have trouble sleeping. It's just I don't have any problem sleeping. It's the fact that I'm a light sleeper that bothers me. and I hear every step and every toilet flush and every door close, and then my sleep is interrupted. So I decided that I wouldn't consume it for a have fun thing or to eat thing or because I'm bored thing. I will consume it simply because I just want a really good night's rest. That's it. And I also understand the consequences of that. I understand that when you are high, drunk, or whatever it may be, you are vulnerable to the devil. You just are. I pray before I smoke, so that way I'm covered in the blood of God. That way, when I do go to sleep, I'm not having weird, wicked dreams and sexual dreams and stuff like that, because they do try to get me like that. I've had a few, honestly, and I had to, you know, get up out of my bed when I wake up and get on my knees and pray and rebuke it, simply because they were getting to me. But all you have to do is be willing to just drop those things. I was willing to stop it because I knew I wanted my life to be better than it was. I knew I wanted to communicate with God more. I knew I wanted him to talk to me. I knew I wanted to be able to talk to him throughout the day. Now I can randomly be like, hey God, what is this? Or God, da 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 da. Or God, you see this? You know, I can talk to him throughout the day. I don't have to worry about, am I high right now? Is he going to hear me right now? Or da da da, you know? It's levels to it. Eventually, I will become a non-smoker. Eventually. But right now, I'm no longer placing it above my Father. I'm not spending my days high. I'm not spending my days just sitting there bored, not doing anything. I spend my days serving God in whatever way that I possibly can. Posting on TikTok, posting on YouTube, posting statuses at church, whatever way I can feel like I can give glory to God, I do. So the third thing you want to do when you build a relationship with God, you got to understand that God has feelings. He's not some stoic being, like he's just hard rock. He has feelings. So just like how you care if you hurt your parents' feelings or your friend or your boyfriend or whoever may be important to you, just like how you care when you hurt their feelings, care when you hurt God's feelings. And how you hurt his feelings is by sinning. Like I said before, God doesn't expect us to stop sinning. He expects us to obey him. So when you have a temptation in your face to go to this party, when you know you should be at home reading your Bible because you didn't do it today, that in that instance, you would care about God's feelings. You know what? I didn't spend time with God today. I didn't open my Bible. I didn't speak to him at all. Let me do that. Now I'm not going to go to your party. I'm not going to hang out with you right now. I want to hang out with God and my Bible. Now, you may be talked about. You may be looked at like you're weird. But that does not matter. God don't care about that. He wants you to spend time with him so he can get to know you, the real you that you were meant to be. Not the you that lived in the world. The you he made you to be. And he honestly wants you to get to know him, so you can possess all his power on this earth. Because once you know God, once you know Jesus, you get a power with your words. You get power with the Bible. So you can use it to defeat the evil of the day. And last but not least, how to build a relationship with God is ask him to reveal what he wants you to do. A lot of us are doing our own will. We're doing what we want to do. Well, maybe I should get a job and go to school and do that and da 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 da. And then wonder why it's a struggle. Wonder why you're having a hard time keeping up with whatever you're trying to do, is because you're going against the grain of what God has for you. God wanted me to work. I worked last year. I had a job all last year. Earlier this year, I quit the job because they were only giving me one day a week. I took that as a sign that, okay, God don't want me there no more. Because if God wanted me there, he would have had me there. So I've been the majority of the year without a job. However, all of my needs have been met. And honestly, if I hadn't stopped working, my relationship with God hadn't grown where it would have grown to. I wouldn't have spent 2-3 hours in my Bible every day if I had a job. Because I would have had to be at work. And I would have been, when I got home, I'd have been too tired and came up with all type of excuses. God has us where he has us for a reason. So ask him, what do you want me to do, Father? Do you want me to have this job? Do you want me to keep this job? Do you want me? You have to have full faith. The Bible says if you have faith of a mustard seed, just a mustard seed. I know a lot of you may not know how small a mustard seed is, but a mustard seed is almost a crumb. If you have faith just that much, he will do wonders through you. You will be a walking testimony. Take that into thought. But if you guys like these videos and you want more, go ahead and hit that thumbs up for your girl that one time. And as always, if you are new and you want to know more about Christ and more about yourself through Christ, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. And as always, I will see you, or you will see me, next time. Bye.